difference going on. And with us, we have the FC Goa head coach Manolo Márquez and midfielder Mohamed Nabil. Without any further ado, I'll throw the floor open to questions. We'll begin with questions for Nabil and then later move on to questions for coach. So tomorrow is a very important game for us. We have the chance to like finish as high up in the table as possible, second or third. And the team has been doing well recently, couple of wins and all that back to back. So how is the mentality of the team like, as a player within the team? Can you tell us about it?
Yeah, I think we are very confident about the match tomorrow, and we believe in ourselves, and we surely win the match tomorrow.
You haven't played as regularly as you would have perhaps liked. How do you keep yourself motivating, and what keeps you going at FC Goa?
So yeah, I haven't been playing a lot of time, but still I think I'm really working hard at the pitch, and I'm just waiting for my chance. It's not about individual thing. I'm not looking at my individual thing. It's about the team that we wanted to really win the. We wanted to win the shield, but it's not possible now. So we're looking forward to the cup.
You play in a position where a lot of clubs prefer to have foreign players. Have you sometimes thought maybe you could move somewhere else, or are you firm in playing as a number 10, which is your specific position? How do you look at that?
So I think that's the reason why I coach sometimes between the left or left winger or right winger, and I'm totally okay with it. I'm happy that I'm getting to play on the field, that's all.
Any more questions for me? Alright, we want to listen for this.
Since Nabil is here, he plays in a very specific position where a lot of foreign players are largely used. Sometimes we have used Brandon also there, a largely experienced player. What do you tell a player like Nabil, who obviously has a talent but still needs to do a lot more?
I think the reason is clear. Even we spoke a lot about this situation. Not only Nabil, no? We spoke about Bryson and other players, and other young players. But it's true. The reality is that usually in these positions, not only is foreigners, we have a lot of players in these positions. And players who play winger, who can play even attacking midfielder. Yasir was with me before, played attacking midfielder too. But the thing is more about he knows, it's more. I think nobody is doubting about the quality of Nabil. Nobody. The thing is that I told him personally, and I think that one day he will have this continuity, not in the games. I'm speaking about the continuity in all training sessions, and sometimes, not only Nabil, about the small injuries now. Last week he was sick. And sometimes in some moments he had very bad luck, because he was almost ready to enter in the pitch, and we scored twice or three times, I think, in the game, and then you decide to change because the substitution was for another reason, because he's a player who scored goals, and then important this in football. But I think my opinion, maybe with another coach he would play, or this kind of players would play more minutes. But it's about for me it's about continuity. One player, not now I'm not speaking about one specific player, but one player who trained very good during 2 weeks, and then because he doesn't play, then again, it's finally
is about, I can tell you a lot of examples that players that they are waiting for his moment, but they are training hard, come on, let's go, and finally you have to be ready, because when your chance arrives, because your chance will arrive, then is your moment, and then you have to enter in the team and try to be there for a long time. Yes.
Coach, how do you approach the match against Chennai tomorrow? It's the last league match. Chennai have got nothing, because anyhow they will finish sixth. But for FC Goa, there is a possibility that you could finish second, or maybe you could even finish third. So how do you approach the game?
No, we want and we need to win. Imagine that tomorrow we don't win and Mumbai win in Kolkata, then I think that we would regret, no, about this situation. Then the thing is that we need to win tomorrow. I don't know if Chennai, if the players, because I was in the same situation than Chennai last season, that at home against Jamshedpur, I played with all the players that usually they didn't play, and when you put all these players together, it's a problem too, also. Then, but the thing is not the game tomorrow, the thing is the important game. For Chennai is the next game. For us, the important game is tomorrow, because we still have chance. We don't depend from our team. But again, finally, you need to win the game tomorrow.
But you still have to strike a balance, because if you go all out in the match against Chennai and four of your players are on three yellow cards, so if you miss the players maybe for an important match like the playoff, or maybe even the semi-final?
No, this is a question for Owen Coyle. Last season, when I did this, I put the non-starter players that usually were playing in the team, but even this doesn't mean that they will come here on holidays, on vacation, no? Of course, the players in this case, Chennai, they have to play in 4 or 5 days another game. I don't know, in Kolkata, or I hope in Kolkata, or in Goa, and the players they will want to show that they can play. Then sometimes I know that is like a topic, but it's a reality. Sometimes when you play with this kind of players in this kind of situations, even can be more dangerous, but we cannot control this. We can control. We can try to do our best, and we will try to win the game. And if we have to play with the players with 3 yellow cards, they will play tomorrow. It's not the same case than Hyderabad, when we play against Hyderabad.
Any more questions?
Coach, your thoughts on Chennai coach?
Coach?
Yeah.
I did not play them, but I don't need. The numbers speak, no? He arrived in India a long time ago, in the middle of the season, when Chennai was, I don't know if it was in the bottom, but close, and he arrived to the final. A coach with a lot of experience. He was a great player, he was a great striker. And he's obviously one coach that is demanding the players during 90, 95 minutes. They have a very good start with Sandy too, that is a long time together. The team is incredible, no? Because finally, in this case, the mentality of the coach was very clear in the game. Not only because they turned, but of course, the last 3 games, you know, they won Odisha, but then they lost at home against Hyderabad, and maybe another team after this game is finished. No, they turned in Kolkata, at home against Jamshedpur, at home against Northeast, and they deserve
to be the in the playoffs, and these kind of teams who arrive in this with this situation, mental situation, are very dangerous. But will be very very difficult for us, but for them also. But let's see if we can play only tomorrow against them. Maybe we can meet in the final then.
Coach, you say we need to win this game because we have our goals and all that. Do you think, in such a situation, do you think it would be like it is extra beneficial that we are playing at home?
Yes, it's better to play at home because we like to play.
I mean, does that give you a clear advantage? Do you think so?
Yes, but finally. Now I will explain why I'm laughing. But it's an advantage for us to play at home. We prefer to play at home than the other day. My travel to Spain was the same hours to go to the game. Then was, I think for us it's better to play at home. I think the team feels, even that we lost two games in Fatorda and only one away, but I think the team is more comfortable when we play at home.
Any more questions? All right.